everyone. We celebrate the feast of the Immaculate Conception of Mary. We begin in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you. Probably of the things in the church, this is the one that is most misunderstood, because the readings aren't exactly what this is about. The teaching of the church about the Immaculate Conception is that Mary was conceived without sin, because that way it would pave the way for her to give birth to the Savior. So it's about her conception, not her conceiving Jesus. For the times we doubted God, we ask God's forgiveness, and so we pray, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
We glorify God as we pray, glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sin of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, and the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. O God, who by the Immaculate Conception of the Blessed Virgin Mary prepared a worthy dwelling for your Son, grant that as you preserved her from every stain by virtue of the death of your Son, which you foresaw, so that through her intercession we may be cleansed and admitted to your presence through Christ our Lord.
A reading from the book of Genesis. After the man, Adam, had eaten of the tree, the Lord God called to the man and asked him, "Where are you?" He answered, "I heard you in the garden, but I was afraid because I was naked, so I hid myself." Then he asked, "Who told you that you were naked? You have eaten then from the tree of which I have forbidden you to eat." The man replied, "The woman whom you put here with me, she gave me fruit from the tree, and so I ate it." The Lord God then asked the woman, "Why did you do such a thing?" The woman answered, "The serpent tricked me into it, so I ate it." Then the Lord God said to the serpent, "Because you have done this, you shall be banned from all animals and from all the wild creatures. On your belly shall you crawl, and dirt shall you eat all the days of your life. I will put enmity between you and the woman, and between your offspring and hers. He will strike at your head while you strike at his heel." The man called his wife Eve, because she became the mother of all the living, the word of the Lord. The responsorial song. Sing to the Lord a new song, for he has done marvelous deeds. Sing to the Lord a new song, for he has done marvelous deeds. Sing to the Lord a new song, for he has done wondrous deeds. His right hand has won victory for him, his holy arm. Sing to the Lord a new song, for he has done marvelous deeds. The Lord has made his salvation known. In the sight of the nations he has revealed his justice. He has remembered his kindness and his faithfulness toward the house of Israel. Sing to the Lord a new song, for he has done marvelous deeds. All the ends of the earth have seen the salvation by our God. Sing joyfully to the Lord, all your lands. Break into song, sing praise. Sing to the Lord a new song, for he has done marvelous deeds. A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. Brothers and sisters, blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has blessed us in Christ with every spiritual blessing in the heavens. And he chose us in him before the foundation of the world to be holy and without blemish before him. In love, he destined us for adoption to himself through Jesus Christ, in accord with the favor of his will, for the praise of the glory of his grace that he granted us in the beloved. In him we were also chosen, destined in accord with the purpose of the one who accomplishes all things according to the intentions of his will, so that we might exist for the praise of his glory, we who first hoped in Christ. Word of the Lord.
Friends, may the Lord be with you. Let us be attentive to the reading of the Holy Gospel according to Luke. The angel Gabriel was sent from God to a town of Galilee called Nazareth, to a virgin betrothed to a man named Joseph of the house of David. The virgin's name was Mary. And coming to her, he said, "Hail, full of grace, the Lord is with you." But she was greatly troubled at what was said and pondered what sort of greeting this might be. Then the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. Behold, you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you will name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called Son of the Most High. And the Lord God will give him the throne of David, his father. He will rule over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end." But Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, since I have no relations with a man?" And the angel said to her in reply, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore the child to be born will be called Holy, the Son of God. And behold, Elizabeth, your relative, has also conceived a son in her old age. And this is the sixth month for her who was called barren, for nothing will be impossible for God." Mary said, "Behold, I am the handmaid of the Lord. May it be done to me according to your word." Then the angel departed from her. The Gospel of the Lord. So you can see where we get the misunderstanding of the Immaculate Conception. And you know what? Really, the big picture is what really matters here. Not that we get wrong what the Immaculate Conception is. It's about Mary and her willingness to serve God. This was years ago. A friend of mine, she's a nun, and she was helping with a little Christmas play. It was the kids in religious education, CCD, that were putting on a little Christmas play, and this one little boy was playing the part of Jesus. And of course, his mother would practice with this little guy over and over and over again. He wasn't able to read, so she practiced his lines with him. And he really only had one line he had to say in the whole little skit. He was supposed to say, "I am the light of the world." So mom practiced with him and practiced with him, practiced with him, and the day of the little skit was going to take place. It was a Sunday morning after the first mass. All the kids were down in the church basement, and the play starts to take place. His mom is sitting in the front row, and she's, of course, nervous and excited for him. And he comes out at the appropriate time, and he freezes. He's not saying anything. So his mother in the front row is mouthing to him, just, "I am the light of the world." But she's not saying it, she's mouthing it to him. And so he still wasn't getting it. He looked bewildered, so she finally leans forward and she says, "I am the light of the world." Little boy smiles and he says, "My mother is the light of the world." And that kind of set things in motion for the rest of the play. But you know what? I'm sure Jesus thought that about his mother, because Mary was an incredible woman. When you think about it, most scholars believe she was maybe 13, 14 years old when all this stuff started to happen to her. She didn't get it. She didn't understand. She didn't know the end of the story. And all these things were going to happen, and we're told that she still trusted that God's words to her would be fulfilled. So I ask us on today, the Feast of the Immaculate Conception, that Mary was conceived without sin, even with all that, she still believed that even though life didn't make sense, even though she had no answers as to who, what, when, where, how, and why, she still believed that God's words to her would be fulfilled. I ask you, do you believe the same thing? God bless. We believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there, he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sin, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. We now offer these prayers. That we too may be able to put our faith, our hope, and our trust in God, we pray. For those we have judged harshly, we pray. For those who have judged us harshly, we pray. that during this season of Advent, may we truly be a people that truly become the light of one another's life, we pray. God, our Father, we ask you to hear our prayer. Shed your light upon our lives through Christ our Lord. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation. Through your goodness, we have this bread to give you, which earth has given and human hands have made. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation. Through your goodness, we have this wine to give you, fruit of the vine, work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink. Friends, let us pray that our gifts will be acceptable to God, our loving Father. Graciously accept the sacrifice by which we offer you, O Lord, and the solemnity of the Immaculate Conception of the Blessed Virgin Mary, and grant that as we profess her on account of your grace to be untouched by the stain of sin, that through her intercession we may be delivered from all of our faults through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. You preserve the most blessed Virgin Mary from all stain of original sin, so that in her, endowed with the rich fullness of your grace, you might prepare a worthy mother for your Son and signify the beginning of the church, his beautiful bride without spot or wrinkle. And so we join our loved ones in heaven as we pray this hymn of unending praise. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." Similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Once more, giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sin. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you've held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Lord, remember your church spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Joseph our Bishop. Remember Celia Gadula, the deceased members of the Grasso and Current families, Dorothy Coolbaugh, Jack and Carmela Salvaggio, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that they were united with your Son in a death like his, may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, for all those who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that together with the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, Joseph, her husband, the apostles, the martyrs, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, may we merit to be co-heirs of eternal life, may we praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. We now pray as Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, from every evil, and graciously grant peace in our day, that by the help of your mercy we may be free from sin and safe from all distress, as we wait with joyful hope the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not in our sin, but on the faith of the church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who will live and reign forever and ever. May the peace of our Lord be with each one of you. Let's offer to one another a sign of God's love. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sin of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Let us pray. May the sacrament we received, O Lord our God, heal in our wounds of the fault that comes from the singular way you preserved the Blessed Virgin Mary and her Immaculate Conception through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. May God's blessing guide us in all that we do, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Let us go now in peace to love and serve the Lord. Have a good day, everyone.